Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick coming to you outside all the FEMA regions of the United States here in the Philippines. Hope you guys are doing all right. You're blessed today by the grace of God and by His mercies. I wanted to share a dream I had with you, brothers and sisters, and first I would just ask a prayer request that we're preparing to go back to the U.S. In about 2 weeks. I ask you guys to pray for our traveling mercies. Pray that we'll find a vehicle to be, you know, a good price or whatnot. And also praying about, where we will, rent a place while I'm there for the rest of 2015. By the grace of God, I'll be in the U.S. until the end of the year, 6-7 months, whatever it is, and then back here to the Philippines in January to work on the next orphanage. While I'm in the States, I hope to visit as many as I can. For praying with people to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit, praying with people for healings, praying with people for words of wisdom, words of knowledge, and also, of course, water baptism, all those things. I have lots of people in Seattle and Southern Canada that I have promised that I will see them, and I know by the grace of God, the Lord wants me to go up there to the Northwest, Pacific Northwest, and many other places as the Lord leads. Praise God, brothers and sisters. And so now that I mentioned that, let's make a schedule for June. How about visiting? Anyway, brothers and sisters, I had this dream. And if you've been following my videos for a long time, and like I say, I'll ask Sister Rosemary if she can put some a playlist maybe on here of the words that the Lord gave me about the new Pope and about end times that would be related to that. I had a dream about the new Pope with this book that had a dragon coming out of it. And I'm going to put the link for that myself. I already looked at that a little while ago before I made this video. And there's lots more. But the thing is, brothers and sisters, the Lord was picked us in line upon line, precept upon precept, here a little, there a little, the Bible says. And so the Lord would give us through a glass darkly, piece by piece, we put it together. As the Bible says also, us together as the body of Christ, there's a wisdom in the multitude of counsel. So we can put all these things together. I'm just putting together the things that the Lord has shown me. But anyway, I had this new dream about the former Pope, who's still alive, the Pope Emeritus. He was Cardinal Ratzinger. Then he became Pope Benedict. Now, after I had my dream, as I was praying about it later on during this day, asking the Lord about it, and the Lord told me, he is Pope Benedict, which is the Benedictine order, which is even in the prophecy of the popes. It says in the St. Malachi prophecy that he is the glory of the olive, referring to the Olivet Discourse, referring to Matthew 24. These high theologians call it the Olivet Discourse. And you're talking about the tribulation period. And that's what the Lord told me while I was awake today, that's why, he's called the glory of the olive. Now, I will say this, the interpretation of my dream. Does Pope, will Pope Benedict still live? How long? I don't know. And will it be him or the school he came from, the Benedictine order, maybe? So that's the thing about interpretation. And, unless the Lord tells me, which he may, that a Benedictine order or Pope Ratzinger himself, Cardinal Ratzinger himself will lead a group of people to do what's right against this Book of the Dragon. Or the Benedictine order will do that. That's why they're called it'll end up being that their name Benedictine order is a prophetic meaning. That they will be or maybe the people that are followers of his school, all of these cardinals and all these popes, they kind of have their own school of theology and all that or whatever. They create like a kind of a whole way of doing things, and then people will make order, in the Catholic Church, they make order out of everything. There'll be order out of doing things the way he was doing it. I just mentioned in the last video, I'll say it again, this is a disclaimer. I'm not a Catholic. I'm not endorsing Catholicism teachings or anything like that. I'm a born again. I came from Assemblies of God preacher. I was a Baptist and Assemblies of God preacher. So I'm not endorsing Catholicism. What I'm trying to tell you as I'm about to explain the dream to you and I'm giving you some interpretation. What I'm trying to tell you is that A, God is the judge. B, or even what should be A, is that the reformers were Catholic priests. So there are Catholic priests who are born again. There are Catholic priests who think they can change the Catholic Church. There are Catholic priests who are men of God, and then God will use them, just like he did, as I mentioned before, Jonathan Huss and Prague. There's many of them. The famous ones, you know, Martin Luther, people like that. There are priests who stood against the false doctrine in Rome. And, of course, many of them, it cost them their life, like Jonathan Huss, he was burned at the stake. Martin Luther was not killed because he was protected by the royals of Germany. But they wanted to kill him. So he had someone to protect him. But, you know, God made a way for him. But anyway, brothers and sisters, in my dream, I was there, and the Pope, the former Pope, Ratzinger, Cardinal Ratzinger, Pope Benedict was in the bed, sleeping. And I was there beside him. And what, before I got there, the Lord said, I want you to help him. I want you to help this man. I didn't know who it was. The Lord said, I want you to help him and speak for this man. So I went there, and there was Pope Benedict laying in the bed. And I sat down at the, you know, on the bed too. And he said, you know, we're going to sleep. And I was like, all right. So I laid down on the bed to go to sleep. And then he woke up and he said, wait a minute. There's a bunch of young men. And now I know you meant young priest. Now I know. He says, there's a bunch of young men who we need to talk to. We need to teach them the true gospel. And he said, you know, and I was like trying to say, well, you know, Catholics is like got their own doctrine and all this kind of stuff, you know, and it's not really biblical Christianity, which is true. And he said to me, he said, listen, he said, I'm going to let you do the talking for the gospel. Me and you're going to go, you and I are going to go together, and you, and I'm going to facilitate this. I'm going to make it happen. I'm going to gather the people and do all the ritual stuff. And then when it's time to do the homily, he didn't use the word homily. I'm using that. That's what they call it. But he said, when it's time to preach, I'm going to let you preach. And I said, you can let me preach? And he said, yeah, because you know the gospel better than I do. And you know what to say better than I do. I mean, I know it, but I don't know how to say it like you do. This is what Pope Benedict said to me, which is true. What he said to me is what I would expect him to say in real life, because it's true. And because they don't, you know, not really preaching, they're doing this mass, ceremonial thing. And not really discussing evangelism, you know, evangelizing people the way we, you know, born-again evangelicals do, preachers do. So I said, all right, you know, because I heard the voice. It was kind of like Brother Gary and I had been discussing this. And Brother Gary's been, Bear049 has been discussing his videos about, you know, Peter, when the curtain was let down. I think there it's in Acts chapter 10. And the Lord said, you know, kill and eat. And Peter said, I wouldn't eat anything unclean. And the Lord said to him, don't call anything unclean that I've made clean. Don't call it unclean. And then it was done three times. And the purpose was is that Peter, God was showing Peter in a backwards way, in a metaphoric way, that the Lord would cleanse the Gentiles. And this went to Peter went to Cornelius' house after this. And so the Lord said, to Peter, there's three men here. Go with them. You know, don't ask any questions. Go with these three guys. And they went to Cornelius' house, a centurion, a Gentile, and they got saved. You know, and so Peter, being the sharp tool that he was, he said, I perceive that God is no respecter of persons. You know, when he got there after all that miraculous stuff that God did, you know, so, you know, he had a perception that God was going to save the Gentiles. And so in this case, it was like the Lord was speaking to me like the same thing, you know. Don't call anything unclean that I've called clean. He was referring to some, Benedict. And so when we went out into the hall, we went out into the room. The Lord told me to go with him. And the Holy Spirit was speaking to me in my dream. We went out into the hallway in front of this, you know, like his place he's staying at there. Up there in the mountains of northern Italy at the observatory. there was all these women, and they were dressed in different amounts of exposure of their breasts. Even some of them were even exposing all the way their whole nakedness. But they were wearing like a clothes with different amount of openness to their clothes. In circles, like a circle on here. Some of them showing their breast halfway, some of them all the way, some of them their everything. And I was like, wow, why are they doing this? And, you know, this is like the Pope is here, you know, Benedict is here, and they're doing this in front of him. I mean, they're pretty crazy. Because I thought they at least put on a show in front of the Pope, you know. And the interpretation of that was these were, you know, the harlots in the church. It's not just they were women. They're the harlots of idolatry in the church. You know, people that worship Mary and people that worship the baby Jesus and people that worship the saints, different saints or whatever. They were all there outside the door where the Pope was. And I was like telling Benedict, I said, we're going to get these women to go with us. He's like, no. This message is not for them. So it means to say the message is not for, you know, the majority of the Catholic Church. It was like, let's say it was 80 or 90%. There was 10%. There was these young men representing the priest that he, of course, Benedict would be training priests. And then those priests would be the ones who would evangelize the people. And so it got wild because, you know, my feeling toward Benedict, you know, was changing slowly through this process. Not that I was, like, hating him or anything, but I was, you know, very cautious and very alert against him that, hey, this guy is fake and he's not a Christian and all this, you know. And so I began to start loosening up toward him as we were talking. And then finally, I touched him. And when I did, you know, I received the wisdom from the Holy Spirit that he was saved. Now, he wasn't filled with the Holy Ghost. He wasn't powerfully anointed or anything, but he was like a new babe in Christ. In other words, like he had just got saved. When he woke up on the bed, it was symbolizing him just getting saved. Like I say, is this the man Benedict? And he will lead a true move of God in that church? Or is it his followers? Or is it the Benedictine order? I don't know which of those three. But anyway, it really gets wild. We went outside and it was ice. And then there was this road that was a road made of ice and snow. And then the walls of it, I believe, represents the Catholic Church. And then there were walls of snow up the side, higher than you could see. Or, you know, say maybe not that high, but say 2 meters or 6 feet high. So we were going there. And then the Pope had kind of an entourage of young men who were following around us. And another thing, too, that the Pope Benedict was dressed in white. Not just that the popes a lot of times wear white, but it was significant in this. His white clothes were very brightly white. It wasn't that off-white, antique white that the Pope usually wears. It was a shining white, like righteousness white. You know, so I'd already patted him on his back, and I've, you know, and then to test him, you know, I've touched him, and then I felt that he was born again, but not as, you know, like I said, he wasn't a Pentecostal preacher, but he's born again. And so we kept on going, and then there was these other guys, and then he said to his other guys, he said, hey, you know, who would have thought that, you know, that I would be part of the U.S. Army, and then, you know, the U.S. Army has liberated us and helped us. And he laughed and patted some of his younger guys on the back, and they were laughing and joking. I mean, he was making a joke out of it. And then, you know, and that refers to, of course, the born-again Christianity, you know, army, the harvest army of the Lord, helping him, me representing that. And then we kept going, and then he began to run. And it was like he got more strength and younger. He became younger, and he began to run and run and run. And I was trying to keep up with him. He was running fast and laughing and enjoying himself, and then he started knocking down the wall. He knocked down one of those walls that was blocking around this ice-frozen road, and snow and ice-frozen road. He knocked down one of the walls, and then he even fell down when he knocked it down, and some of his guys ran over there and helped him get up, and he was fine. He was laughing. He was filled with joy. He was happy, and everything was cool. And then I went up to him, and I hugged him, and he hugged me. And we were laughing and rejoicing and, like, jumping up and down and praising God. And then I woke up. So that's the dream that I had, brothers and sisters. And so When I woke up, the Lord immediately told me, remember the dream that I gave you about the Pope, the new Pope. I'm trying to think because I'm thinking of his real name. But his Pope name is, it's slipping my mind. See, the Lord won't even remember. It doesn't matter. I guess he's not really the Pope, right? Borges or what? His name is anyway, Pope Francis. It's so amazing that he took the name Pope Francis of Assisi. And Pope Francis, Francis of Assisi, is someone who I looked at as, you know, of anybody in the Catholic Church that was a man of God, it was Saint Francis of Assisi. You know, during the Crusades, he went down there and told the Muslims that Jesus loved them, you know, which was the right thing to do. We're in here, shouldn't be killing you. We should be loving the Muslims and telling them about Jesus. And that was Francis of Assisi. And Francis of Assisi gave a prophecy that the last pope would lead the church into apostasy, total and complete apostasy. And now, here is this guy taking that name. Now, he's got to know that. I mean, he was a cardinal. He's a doctor of theology. How many times over? How many doctorates he has? Who knows? I've been going to school his whole life because most of those, you know, like the Pope John Paul II speaks 7 languages or 9 languages. They're all, you know, most of them are very smart people. They spend their whole life going to school because they're not married. And, you know, of course, he's a Jesuit, which is the top of the top as far as intellectual education goes. So I'm surely he knows these things. And it's just ironic. And so anyway, brothers and sisters, what I'm trying to say, the interpretation is that there will be a remnant, which God always has a remnant. He always has wheat everywhere. There is a remnant of Catholic priests. As I said, will it be the Benedictine order or Pope Benedict himself? He's pretty old. Or will it be he will train some people and they'll be the ones to do it, his followers in his school of theology? Anyhow, brothers and sisters, there is going to be, and that's why they're the glory of the olive, because during the Olivet time, which is the tribulation, they will be doing mighty things for God. There is a remnant of them that will do mighty things for God during the tribulation. That's what I'm trying to tell you. A lot of people watch my videos are Catholics. So take heart. Of course, the Lord, you know, even though the Catholic Church as an institution, like in my other dream, the Lord showed me that in my, you know, that's what the Lord was reminding me of. In that dream, which I put the link below here, there was one cardinal who specifically fought hard against this Book of the Dragon. And the rest of the cardinals almost completely were in support of the Book of the Dragon to brainwash all the people. And then at least one cardinal I mentioned in that dream I had, and it seems like there were some more probably that were fighting against it, but not like this one guy. Maybe that was Cardinal Ratzinger. I didn't see that it was him in the dream, the other dream. But, you know, in other words, they will lose the institutional battle, but, you know, they're going to be there. God will have godly priests there to help, who will be born again, who's going to help, you know, those people in the Catholic Church who are left behind, you know, the sheep, to get saved. I mean, you know, God has a plan for everything, brothers and sisters. So let's pray for this. Let's pray for the conversion of Pope Benedict. Let's pray for the, you know, the salvation of these people who will, you know, that those priests. And then in my dream, you know, I was going with him to evangelize them, to lead them to salvation. Now, will it be me literally or other, you know, the church will do, you know, the born-again church will do that? I don't know. Pray that it comes to pass and be a reality, brothers and sisters, by the grace of God. God bless you guys. I got to run because I'm getting into all this other stuff. But anyway, I had a dream too that the mark of the beast was a stargate, a swirl stargate. And I looked and that thing was opening up. I mentioned it in the last video, but I didn't get into it about CERN. I believe that's what it is, a stargate, of course. I've been talking about it for several years, since I've been making videos. God bless you guys.